Welcome back to the next session of progressions. We are in the process of doing the problems of arithmetic progression from additional question bank of ICMA table. Let's see question number 37. The sum of all natural numbers from 100 to 300 excluding those which are divisible by Look at the question, sir. We have to calculate the sum of all the natural numbers from 100 to 300, excluding those which are divisible by 4. So it's a two-step process. What will I do first? I'll calculate the sum of all natural numbers from 100 to 300. From this grand sum, let us calculate the numbers sum which are divisible by 4. So step number 1. Sum of all natural numbers from 100 to 300 is n by 2 into a plus l, number of terms. From means first term and last term also you have to include. 201 divided by 2 into 100 plus 300. This is 201 by 2 into 400. So this is 40,100. 200 into 201. 40,100. Now step 2. Numbers divisible by 4. 100, 104, 108, etc. 300. 100 104, 108, etc. 300. N is equal to last term minus first term divided by common difference plus 1. Last term is 300, first term is 100 by 4 plus 1. 200 by 4 means 50 plus 1, 51. How many numbers are there? 51 numbers are there from 100 to 300 which are divisible by 4. So S51 is equal to 51 by 2 into A plus L, 100 plus 300. 51 by 2 into 400, it will go 2 times. This is 1000. 200. Here 201 into 200 means 40,200. So from 40,200, if I subtract 10,200, I'll get 30,000. So sum of all the natural numbers from 100 to 300, excluding those which are divisible by 4, is 10,000. Is 30,000. That is the answer to the given question. Next question. Now look at the question number 40. The sum of all natural numbers, the sum of all natural numbers from 100 to 300, from 100 to 300 which are divisible by four or five is this is my question. Let's see the question again. You want sum of all the natural numbers from 100 to 300 which are divisible by 4 or 5. Let me explain the concept with the help of an app. Let us take this as set which contains numbers divisible by 4. This is numbers divisible by 5. Numbers divisible by 5. So this part is what? Numbers divisible by 5. Okay. Now sir, when you are calculating the sum of all the natural numbers which are divisible by 4, this part is included one time. Again, when you are calculating the sum of the numbers which are divisible by 5, this part is included one more time. It means the numbers which are divisible by 4 and 5 is double counted. So, sum of all natural numbers from 100 to 300 which are divisible by 4 or 5 is equal to sum of all numbers divisible by 5 plus sum of all numbers divisible by 4 minus sum of all numbers divisible by 4 and 5 divisible by 4 and 5. Okay, so first we have to calculate the sum of all those numbers which are divisible by 5. Okay sir, now let me eliminate this diagram from the picture. Numbers divisible by 5. 100 is the first number which is divisible by 5. 105 is the next number which is divisible by 5. 110, etc. 300. So n is equal to last term minus first term divided by common difference plus 1. So 41 numbers are there. How many numbers we have? 41 numbers which are divisible by 5. So S41 is equal to 41 by 2 into A plus L, first term plus last term. So this is 41 by 2 into 400. This is 8200. Next, numbers divisible by 4, 100, 104, 108, etc. 300. Once again, n is equal to last term minus first term by common difference plus 1, 51. S51 is 51 by 2 into A plus L, 100 plus 300. So 400 means it is 10,200. Two values are obtained. Third one. Numbers divisible by 4 into 5, that is by 20. Numbers are divisible by 4 and 5, that is 20. 100, 120, 140, etc. 300. 100, 120, 140, etc. 300. N is equal to last term minus first term by common difference plus 1. 10 plus 1, 11 numbers are there. 200 by 20 means 10 plus 1, 11. S11 is equal to 11 by 2 into A plus L. 100 plus 300. 11 by 2 into 400. It will go 2 times 2200. So required sum is equal to 8200 plus 10200 minus 2200. So this is 16200. So required sum is equal to 16200. Okay. Next question. Question number 41. If the nth terms of 2 AB is are in the ratio 3n plus 4 is to n plus 4, the ratio of the fourth terms of two series is, this is my question. Look at this, sir. What is given to you? The sum to n terms of, sorry, the general terms, ratio of nth terms of two series. It is given, solution. Tn is to t dash n is equal to 3n plus 1 is to n plus 4. 3n plus 4 is to n plus 4. So Tn by T dash n is equal to 3n plus 4 divided by n plus 4. N plus 4. Now, fourth terms of the two series. 3 into 4 plus 4 divided by 4 plus 4. 12 plus 4 is 16 by 8, 2 by 1. So T4 is 2, T dash 4 is 2 is to 1. T4 is 2, T dash 4 is 2 is to 1. Next 45 question number. Find the three numbers in AB. Find the three numbers in AB whose sum is 27. And the sum of their squares is 341. Now we have options. (2, 9, 16). Option B. 16, 9, 2. Option C. Both A and B. Option D. -2, -9, -16. Okay. Solution. Let us see, sir. When our options are numerical numbers, then you can verify the conditions from options. I want the three numbers. T1, T2, T3 be the three terms. First condition. T2 minus T1 is equal to T3 minus T2. The given problem or the given options has to satisfy the three conditions. Under these three, first one is common difference should be same. So T2 minus T1 is equal to T3 minus T2. Second one, sum is equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3. This is 27. Third one, sum of their squares, T1 square plus T2 square plus T3 square. This is equal to 341. So the option which satisfies these two conditions is my answer. The option which satisfies these two conditions. Look at this, sir. Option A. 9 minus 2 is equal to 7. 16 minus 9 is equal to 7. 9 minus 2 is equal to 7. 16 minus 9 is equal to 7. Common difference is same. First condition is satisfied. Second condition. S is equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3. This is 2 plus 9 plus 16. This is 27. Third condition, sum of their squares, 2 square plus 9 square plus 16 square. So 16, 16 are 256. 256 plus 81 plus 4, 341. This is 341. So option A has satisfied all the conditions. Option A has satisfied all the conditions given. Option B. 16, 9, 2. First condition. 9 minus 16 is minus 7. 2 minus 9 is minus 7. Here common difference is minus 2. Common difference is there. Same numbers in reverse order. So second condition, sum T1 plus T2 plus T3, 16 plus 9 plus 2, 37, this is 27, sum of their squares, T1 square plus T2 square plus T3 square, 16 square plus 9 square plus 2 square, 341. Option A and option B satisfied all the conditions given in the question. Therefore, option C is the answer. Option C, both A and B is the answer to the given question. Okay. Look at the question number 48. The four numbers in AP. The four numbers in AP with the sum of second and third being 22 and product of the first and fourth being 85 R. Let's go with option A. 3, 5, 7, 9. Option B. 2, 4, 6, 8. Option C. 5, 9, 13, and 17. Option D. Okay, sir. Look at the solution for this. Four members I want. T1, T2, T3, T4. Be the four numbers. So first condition, T2 minus T1 is equal to T3 minus T2 is equal to T4 minus T3. The numbers has to satisfy this condition. Next, sum of the second and third, T2 plus T3, second and third is equal to 22, comma, product of first and fourth. T1 into T4 is equal to 85. So the option which satisfies these conditions is my answer. Let's go with option A. 3, 5, 7, 9. 5 minus 3 is equal to 7 minus 5 is equal to 9 minus 7 equal to 2. 5 minus 3 is equal to 7 minus 5 is equal to 9 minus 7 equal to 2. Common difference is same, so they are in arithmetic progression. Next, second term plus third term is equal to sum of second and third. T2 plus T3, 5 plus 7 is 12, 5 plus 12, second is 12. This is not equal to 22. Option A is not my answer. Let me proceed to option B. 2, 4, 6, 8. 4 minus 2, 6 minus 4, 8 minus 6 is 2. First condition satisfied. Second and third, T2 plus T3 is equal to 4 plus 6. This is not equal to 22. Option B is not my answer. Option C. 5, 9, 13, 17. 9 minus 5 is 9, 13 minus 9 is 17, minus 13 is 4. 9 minus 5 is equal to 13 minus 9 is equal to 17 minus 13. This is 4. First condition satisfied. T2 plus T3. This is 9 plus 13. 22. Second condition also satisfied. Third condition, T1 into T4. This is 5 into 17, 85. So option C satisfied all the conditions given in the problem. Therefore, it is the answer to the given question. It is the answer to the given question. Next. Look at the question number 52. The sum of n terms of a plus b, 2a, 3a minus b, etc. is. This is my question. Now look at this, sir. First term is equal to a plus b. Common difference is second term minus first term. A minus b. Let me check up third term minus second term. So a minus b, common difference is same. It is in arithmetic progression. So s is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, 2a 2 into a plus b plus n minus 1 into common difference a minus b. 2a plus 2b minus n into a minus b minus a plus b. So this is n by 2 into 2a minus a means a, 2b plus b means 3b minus n into a minus b. This way option is given. Okay, now let us see question number 53. Sum of n terms of is. No, sir. Solution. First term is x plus y whole square, x square plus y square plus 2xy. Common difference, second term minus first term. Minus 2xy. Common difference here is minus 2xy. Let me verify third term minus second term also. X minus y whole square minus x square plus y square. x square plus y square minus 2xy minus x square minus y square. So minus 2xy, common difference is same. Then we can go for sum. N by 2 into 2a, 2 into x plus y whole square minus n minus 1 into common difference is minus 2xy. So I can take 2 as common. X plus y whole square minus of minus plus n minus 1 into xy. 2 cancel, n into. Let me see the options how it is given. It is n is taken inside, so n into x plus y whole square plus n into n minus 1 into xy, sum is equal to this way it is given. Let's see the next question, sir. Question number 55. The sum of n terms of one into four plus three into seven plus five into ten plus etc. up to n terms is question. Okay, sir. Let us see option A. Sn is equal to n by 2 into 4n square plus 5n minus 1. Option B, Sn is equal to n into 4n square plus 5n minus 1. Option C, n by 2 into 4n square minus 5n minus 1. Option D, none of this. Okay. Now this is coming under the heading of special series. As it is, if I consider it is 4 plus 21 plus 50, it is not in arithmetic progression. But if you separate all the first terms, 1 comma 3 comma 5 comma 7, it is in arithmetic progression. Again 4 comma 7 comma 10 comma etc. If I separate all the second terms, again it is in arithmetic progression. Okay. For these type of problems, descriptive procedure is very lengthy. But we have a concept of objective type which is very simple. Let us see that concept. Suppose I have a series with only one term. When a series is having only one term, you can write it as S1 is equal to T1. When a series is having two terms, S2 is equal to T1 plus T2. When a series is having three terms, S3 is equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3. Etc. If I proceed, Sn is equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus etc. plus Tn. T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus etc. Tn. This way it is going on. Now what will I do? I'll take the help of substitution, that is options. For every problem of this type, I'll verify whether S2 is equal to T1 plus T2 or not by taking n is equal to 2 in the options, because options are sum. Given problem is in terms of terms. Let us see the solution, sir. T1 is equal to 1 into 4, this is 4. T2 is equal to 3 into 7, this is 21. T1 plus T2 is equal to 4 plus 21, 25. T1 plus T2 is equal to 4 plus 21, this is 25. What will I do now? I'll substitute n is equal to 2 in the options. You can take n is equal to 1 also, this condition. Or you can take n is equal to 3, this condition. Okay. So I'm taking n is equal to 2. For option A, when n is equal to 2, S2 is equal to option A, 2 by 2 into 4 times 2 square, 5 times 2 minus 1, 2 cancel, 4 into 4, 4 into 4, 16, 5 into 2, 10, minus 1. 26 minus 1, 25. For option A, S2 is equal to T1 plus T2 condition satisfied. This is my answer. Okay. For your satisfaction, I'm taking N is equal to 2 in option B also. Let's see. I know the answer now. Just verify for confirmation. S2 is equal to 2 into 4 into 2 square plus 5 into 2 minus 1, 16 plus 25, 16 plus 10, 26 minus 1, 2 into 25, this is 50. S2 is not equal to T1 plus T2, S2 is not equal to T1 plus T2, option B is not my answer. Let me proceed to option C. S2 is equal to 2 by 2 into 4 into 2 square minus 5 into 2 minus 1. 2 cancel. 16 minus 10 minus 1. This is 5. Not equal to 25. S2 is not equal to T1 plus T2. Therefore, option C also not the answer. This is the procedure we are having. Both option is not there. Therefore, option A is the answer to the given question. This is induction method, mathematical induction. Just I verified for n is equal to 2, this left hand side is equal to right hand side or not. Answer is updated. This is the way of solving these type of questions. Let me do some more questions so that this concept will be very clear to you. Look at the question number 57. The sum of n terms of one equal to n by 3 into n plus 1 into n minus 2. Option B. Sn is equal to n by 3 into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1. Option C, Sn is equal to n into n plus 1 into n plus 2. Option D is none. This way I have options. Let us see some solution. T1 is equal to 1, T2 is 1 plus 2, 3. So T1 plus T2, 1 plus 3, 4. It is 1 plus 3, 4. Now from options, when n is equal to 2, option A, S2 is equal to 2 by 3, 2 plus 1 into 2 minus 2, this is 0. So this is not equal to T1 plus T2. Option A is not my answer. Let me take option B, S2 is equal to 2 by 3, 2 plus 1, 3, this is 4 plus 1, 3, 3 cancel, 2 into 5, 10, this is not equal to T1 plus T2, option B is not my answer. Let me proceed to option C, S2 is equal to 2 into 3 into 5, so 30. This is not equal to T1 plus T2. Option D is the answer to the given question. Option D, none of this is my answer. Okay. Let's see one more question. Question number 59. The sum of n terms of the series the sum of n terms of the series 2 into 4 into 6 plus 4 into 6 into 8 plus 6 into 8 into 10 plus etc. is option A, Sn is equal to 2n into n cube plus 6n square plus 11n plus 6. Option B, Sn is equal to 2n n cube minus 6n square plus 11n minus 6. Option C, Sn is equal to n into n cube plus 6n square plus 11n plus 6. Option D, n into n cube plus 6n square plus 11n minus 6. This way I have options. Now look at this, sir. T1 is equal to 2 into 4 into 6, 48. T2 is equal to 4 into 6 into 8. This is 4 into 6 into 8, 192. T1 plus T2 is equal to 48 plus 192. 192 plus 48, 240. T1 plus T2 is equal to 240. Now I'll check up which option will satisfy the condition, or which option will give the output as 240 when I replace n with 2. Again, I am repeating this point. After finding out the sum T1 plus T2, I'll take the help of options. Which option will give output as a 240 when I replace n is equal to 2? So let's go from options. A, S2 is equal to 2 into 2, 2 cube, 6 into 2 square, 11 into 2 plus 6. So this is 4 into 8, 24 plus 22 plus 6. 8 plus 22, 30, 24 plus 6, 30. 30 plus 30, 60. So 4 into 60, 240. Therefore, for option A, S2 is equal to T1 plus T2. For option A, S2 is equal to T1 plus T2. Therefore, option A is the answer. Option A is the answer to the given question. Look at the question number 62. The sum to n terms of the series
The sum to n terms of the series 11, 23, 59, 167, etc. is option A, 3 power n plus 1 plus 5n minus 3. Option B, Sn is equal to 3 to the power n plus 1 plus 5n plus 3. Option C, 3 power n plus 5n minus 3. Option D, none. Okay, now see the solution. T1 is equal to 11, T2 is equal to 23, T1 plus T2, 11 plus 23, 34. Let us take the options. Option A, when n is equal to 2, S2 is equal to 2 power 3 plus 5 into 3 minus 3. 3 power 3 means 27. Plus 15 minus 3. Is 39. This is not equal to 34. Option A is not the answer. Let me take option B. S2 is equal to 3 power 3 plus 5n plus 3. So this is 27 plus 15 plus 3. So 18, 45. This is not equal to 34. Option B is not my answer. Let me proceed to option C. S2 is equal to 3 power 2 plus 5 into 3 minus 3. 3 3s are 9, 5 3s are 15 minus 3. So 9 plus 15, 24 means 21. This is not equal to 34. This is not equal to 34. Option D, none of this is the answer.
11 plus 23. When I take n is equal to 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 cube plus 5 into 3, 15, 27 plus 15, 27 plus 15, 42 minus 3, 39. Okay. That's all here, sir. Remaining in the next session. Thank you.